Good morning, my dear student. We have started the lesson separation of substance. In the last video, we have discussed that why there is a need of separation, and we have also discussed that how to separate the solid substance from the mixture. Then we have discussed about the different types of methods how to separate the solid substance from the mixture. There are different methods. That is hand picking, threshing, winnowing, sieving. These are the different methods. So now let's discuss about the separation of insoluble solid, the substances, which how to separate the solid substance from the liquid. Let's consider water. Now let's discuss about the insoluble solid substance. Now insoluble means what? The substance which does not dissolve in water. The substances which does not dissolve in water, they are called as insoluble substance. Are you getting? As we have considered here water, so I have said that insoluble, the substances which does not dissolve in water, they are called as insoluble substance. So in today's video, we are going to discuss about the next point, that is separation of insoluble solid from the liquid. Now here we are going to consider the water. So there are the different method. There are the two methods: salinization, decantation, and filtration. So these are the two methods through which we can separate the insoluble solid substance from the water. Are you getting? So salinization. Now what is the actually the process of salinization? Salinization means what? Settling down the heavier object. Now, as you know, this which season is going on? Yes, rainy season. Now, if you look the water is muddy, right? We get the water from the tap that we get. The water is little bit muddy water. Now, what do you observe? When the water settle down, when it get at a rest position, you can see. After throwing the water, you can see there are the mud which is stick at the bottom of that particular vessel. Yes or no? You might have observed this. So that is nothing but settling down the heavier. What happens? The sand and mud are there, the heavier object. So and it does not dissolve in water. It does not dissolve in water. Now if you will look the water in the river, it is muddy. They take the color of it, but it does not get dissolved in water. The mud settle down at a bottom. So that process is called as a sedimentation. That process is called as a sedimentation. The sand which settle at the bottom of the vessel, that is called as a sediment. And the process when takes place is settling down of the heavier object, that is called as a sedimentation. Are you getting this? I hope you have understood sedimentation. I am going to do this activity so that it will clear. So let's first learn the theory part. Then when we will do the activity again, I will explain you this. Then next is decantation. Now decantation is nothing but, now see, is this a, as it is a rainy season, what happens? The mud gets settled down at the bottom of the vessel, and the clear water is remained upward. So that process is called as a decantation. Now without disturbing the sediment, that is sand, if you will remove that water, that process is called as a decantation. So these are the methods: sedimentation and decantation. This is the process of sedimentation and decantation. The next process is of filtration. So now, as you know, as this is a rainy season, most of the time the instructions are given that we have to drink the boiled water. Am I right? We have to drink the boiled water or filtrate water. Filtration is the process. It is a process of separating insoluble substance from liquid using a filter. Now most of the people have the filter at their home. Am I right? They have the filter at the home, which depends on electricity. So that process is called as a, by using the filter we get a clear water. So that process is called as a filtration. So let's do the activity of sedimentation, decantation and filtration so that this point will be clear for you. Okay, now I will show you the activity. So let's do the practical for the sedimentation and decantation. So for this I have taken the sand which is insoluble in water, and this is a water. So I'll pour some water in this and I'll add some salt in it. Okay, after that I'll mix it well. Let's wait for some minute. You can see the particles will settle down. The mud has settled down, so that is called as a sediment. Okay, if you will wait for some minute, the sand is going to settle down. And now without disturbing the sediment, we have to pour the water in it. So without disturbing it, when you are going to pour the water, you are going to get a clear water, little bit clear water. So what we have done? So this process which I am doing without disturbing the sediment, the water which I am getting, so this process is called as a decantation. Now without disturbing the sediment, what I have done? First I have laid that the sand to settle down. So that process is called as a sedimentation. And without disturbing the sediment, when I pour this water in this, to get a clear water, this process is called as a decantation. The next process is filtration. So let's do the filtration. For this, I'll take one beaker. In that beaker, what I'm going to do? See, this is a beaker and one conical flask, and this is filter paper. Now what is the use of this filter paper? Filter paper has a tiny holes in it. So this, you have to put a filter paper. There is one method to put a filter paper. First you fold this filter paper, then you will make this like a cone shape, okay, and you are going to put in this filter, this conical flask. Now this water which I have removed, so that I can get more clear water, so I am using the filtration. So I will pour this into this. Now you can see I can get more clear water in this filtration. So I will take more water from this. So again, same process, without disturbing the sediment, I'm going to get a clear water, and this I'm going to pour into it so that I can get more clear water. See,
This is a clear water by using the filter paper. So this process is called as a filtration. By using the filter paper, I have get a water. So this process is called as a filtration. Okay, so you can see this. See, some still water is there into it. So one thing, see, can you see? And you can see some particles which are inside this, the sand which is remain on the filter paper. So that is called as a residue. And this water which we got, that is called as a filtrate water. This water is called as a filtrate water. This water which we have got, this is a filtered water. But and the things which are remain on this filter paper, you can see this mud is remain. So that is called as a residue. That leftover part on the filter paper, that is called as a residue. I hope you have understood this practical. Through the practicals we have done the I hope you have understood how we can separate the insoluble substance from the liquid. And there are the different uses of filtration. Filtration we are using, see, if we want a juice, at that time also we need a separation. Are you getting?
Yeah.
So I hope you have understood the separation of the insoluble solid from the liquid. Filtration is used in many ways. We can use, if you want a juice, at that time we remove the seed by using the filter. I mean, we use the stirrer. Even if during tea, the tea lovers, those who love the tea, at that time the tea powder is separated by the stirrer, filter stirrer, am I right? So tea stirrer, that is to separate the tea powder from it, am I right? So these are some methods to separate the insoluble solid from the liquid. So these are the uses of filtration. Now it is very important during rainy season, the filtration of water is most important. Are you getting? I hope you have understood. If you have any doubt, you can ask me during Google Meet.